15 disturbing facts you didn't know about Charles Manson, part 2. If you are brand new to our channel, we invite you to take a moment to subscribe. Just click on the lit red button as well as the gray bell. Why the bell? Well, it will let you know every time we post a new video.
9. Believes he's immortal. Of all the crazy things that Manson has said or done, the fact he believes he's immortal doesn't really rank among the weirdest. In the aftermath of his marriage and breakup with the beautiful and young star, Manson has commented on the situation a number of times, alluding at times to the fact that he was just using her. He has also insinuated that he never had anything to hide from her. If she really wanted his corpse when he died, that was never going to happen. There was never going to be a corpse. Was that because Manson wanted to be cremated? Nope, it's because he is never going to die, ever. At least according to him, and so far, that seems to hold up. 10. Still has obsessed followers today. Timeline.com. It's been nearly 50 years since Charles Manson and his family committed some of the most gruesome murders in American history, but to this day, Manson, who has never been free since, still has followers. It's unclear how many of his followers who were not in prison still follow him, though most of those involved in the killings who are still living have long disavowed both Manson's influence and their support. Manson has always had an unmistakable sway that prosecutor Vincent Bugliosi, who recently died, credits to the lure of evil and general curiosity. In recent years, Manson has accumulated new followers and supporters through the internet and letter writing. At least a few years ago, much of his day was devoted to communication by phone and writing to his new supporters. 11. Believed he communicated with the Beatles. This little tidbit might not be so obscure for followers of the Beatles or Charles Manson. After all, the best-selling book about Manson and his crimes is called Helter Skelter. The obsession with the Beatles ran deep, though, very deep, to the point where Manson believed that the White Album was a prophecy predicting and guiding his actions in this tumultuous period. He would make his followers listen to the album non-stop as he explained that the Beatles were communicating information about an incoming race war and how Manson was going to be a key figure. Songs like Revolution 1 were interpreted as simply a call for a general social revolution, whereas things sometimes got a little more specific. He thought the lyrics from the song I Will, which sung, "Your song will fill the air, sing it loud, so I can hear you," meant that he should make an album to declare to the world he was the new Jesus Christ. He also believed that there was evidence that the Beatles were going to join him in California once he got his revolution underway. Apparently, a number of his followers were shocked when the Beatles did not support Charlie when he was incarcerated. 12. He had a celebrity hit list. Charles Manson had celebrity aspirations from the very start. Long before he plotted out his murder spree, he wanted to be a famous musician. He had learned to play guitar in prison and written a few songs. With the help of his posse of young and attractive teen girls, he managed to make quite a bit of leeway in Hollywood circles, even befriending people like Dennis Wilson of the Beach Boys. When it became clear that Manson's career was not taking off as planned, he started to harbor some violent revenge fantasies. While rumors have always swirled around his crimes, among them is the idea of a death list which included some of the most famous people in the world. According to Manson's follower, Susan Atkins, the family had a celebrity death list which included Steve McQueen, Elizabeth Taylor, Richard Burton, Frank Sinatra and Tom Jones. 13. Broken engagement, she just wanted him for his corpse. For those of you upset that a cult leader serial killer who has been in prison for decades has better luck in love than you, fear not, apparently things were too good to be true. While Star and her family deny it to this day, apparently Star was not interested in Manson for his mind or body. Well, she was for his body, but not the way you think. Star was hoping that in marrying Charles Manson at the time of his death, she would be able to have control of his remains, as Manson has no current relatives who would want anything to do with them. Star apparently wanted to put them on display for either profit or as a part of a larger scheme of devotion, depending on how true her actual belief system is. Some claim, though, that Manson is not heartbroken, and he was just happy to string anyone along willing to bring him cakes and fresh toiletries. 14. At 80, was engaged to a hot 27-year-old. The wistful Star with her long black hair and white-eyed innocence could have stepped right out of the late 1960s and we would not be any of the wiser. Eerily beautiful, slim, with a wide-eyed vacant stare, Star, born as Afton Elaine Burton, could have easily have been one of the original Manson girls. Old enough to be her grandfather, Star has nonetheless said, "I think he's the most handsome man in the world," according to Rolling Stone magazine. She visited him regularly and eventually convinced the ardent anti-marriage Manson to agree to an engagement. While not criminal, the whole thing is incredibly creepy, especially since Star seems pretty convinced that Manson may be innocent. Lest you think things are a little too weird though, don't worry, Manson is not allowed to have conjugal visits. The most physical him and Star get are a kiss and a hug when they meet and depart. 15. Manson rearranged a murder scene. While Charles Manson himself did not commit any of the murders in the Tate residence, he did make sure the scene was dramatic enough. After his followers brutally killed the four people inside the Tate residence, actress Sharon Tate, scriptwriter Wojciech Frykowski, Folger's coffee heiress, Abigail Folger and Jay Sebring, celebrity hairstylist, Manson returned inside. As the murders themselves were meant to point the blame away from the Manson family of misfits, and meant to look more like a political act, according to some sources, Charles Manson rearranged the American flag found in the home to be draped near the dead body of Sharon Tate. This tells you something about his mindset, that in a home full of murdered bodies he's not worried at all, just making sure the scene looks right.